Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, Ustaz. Okay, I want to ask you about what's your opinion about Islam and politics. In Akhirah, we will be asked about us, about why we choose that leader. Because Malaysia will have general election. We have two parties. One party defend and bring Islam. Second party is defend and bring the nation and race and Malaysia. What's your opinion?
Well, I don't know anything about Malaysian politics.
No, just...
But I do have a lot of opinions about Islam and politics, so I'll share that with you, okay? Because I think it's a serious topic. You might not like what I say, but that's okay, because I have a flight soon. No, I'm kidding. In my own studies, when I first, in my early studies of the Quran, I felt like there is a very deep connection between Islam and politics. I no longer believe that. I believe there is a relationship between Islam and politics, but the way that the Muslims talk about it is not very true to the text of the Quran. As a matter of fact, in my understanding, in the entire Quran, maybe one ayah is about governance. Maybe one. أَلَّذِينَ إِمَّكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. That's the only ayah. I don't see any other ayah in which directly governance is talked about. Ahkam of Allah, yes. Justice, yes. But then justice was being talked about in ayat when, at a time when Muslims had no government. As a matter of fact, even the way we think about implementing the ayat of Quran, I feel that we oversimplify things. For example, how many times have you heard, if Allah said it, you must do it? Right? Simple. Allah said it, you must do it. The ayat of Hajj came in Medina, in Baqarah, early Madani ayat. All the ayat are early, before Badr even, some of them. Did the Muslims do Hajj? No. They did Hajj many years later. They were reciting the ayat of Hajj and the manasik and all, but they weren't doing it. Why aren't they doing what Allah said? It's not time yet. It's not time. So we have this kind of, I argue an extreme view of how Islam is applied. Okay? As far as citizenship is concerned, I won't comment on your politics or what party and what candidate, or who's Islamic and who's not Islamic. I would argue that your responsibility as a citizen is to look at the rights of all citizens, not just the Muslim citizens, and to look at the candidates that are best for the nation. What is best for Islam is not the same as what is best for the nation. What is best for Islam is at a community level and at a larger level. Right? But we often assume, that's what I was saying, we think Islam is top down, not bottom up. The vast majority of Islam is bottom up. You can have the most Islamic government and still the most un-Islamic society. And that still means nothing to Allah Azza wa Jalla. It means nothing. You understand what I'm saying? So I think we've over-politicized, I feel, Islam, and I don't think that's the right place for it. In the way that we've used it, at least anyway. I think when it comes to politics, our religion emphasizes basically principles. Justice, transparency, ensuring the rights of others. It's not actually about implementing, oh, we're going to shut down all the stores in Ramadan. Or we're going to make sure the women that don't wear hijab, or something else. Or we're going to burn all the liquor stores. When did that happen in Islamic history? Study the Islamic empires of Granada. You know, and the Andalusia, and they were multicultural, multi-religious, open societies, and they lived by Islam. And they thrived. Some of the greatest civilizations of Islam were like that, right? And if some of the people today that talk about Islam were there, they would be like, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. You know, that's all they would have been doing. We're far more, you know, some of the people that claim Islam today are far more extreme than any time in our history. They're just far more extreme. You know, so we need to get a better understanding of our own history, in my opinion. We don't have that. And we have to get a better understanding of where exactly does Islam and politics interplay. We feel like Islam and politics merge at every occasion. They don't. There are many parts of our life where Allah left us to make our choices. You tell me. I live in America, right? And when I vote, obviously I'm not insane, but I have to pick between two bad choices. I have to pick between insane and evil. I don't know which one to go with. Like, you know. But that, I'm not going to make that choice as a Muslim. I have to make that choice as a citizen. You understand? And my choice is not the Islamic choice. It's the choice based on my common sense. The same is true of you. You're not making an Islamic or un-Islamic choice. You're making a responsible choice as a citizen based on the information that you have. So I feel that Islam is unnecessarily pushed into this space, and it creates a lot of disaster. Because what happens then is, then people are made to feel like, if you vote for this one, you are less Islamic. And if you vote for that one, you are more Islamic. And they're both Muslims. You know, that's just not the case. That's my view, sorry.